As of August 11th of 2024, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is the exact same number that were erupting last week. Of these, the volcano with the longest continuously ongoing eruption is Vanuatu's Yasur volcano, erupting for approximately 800 years straight at a low to moderate intensity. This prolonged activity has all occurred from its ever-growing cinder cone, which in that time span has reached a prominence of 306 meters or 1,004 feet. This cone, which contains one of only 8 active lava lakes on the planet, has produced eruptions that could best be described as explosive, primarily having a Strombolian to Vulcanian nature. Those of you who have followed my channel for a long time appreciate my discussion of geologic and volcanic news stories since I am a knowledgeable geologist. Yet, not everyone who discusses these same stories in news outlets has a similar background in earth sciences. That's why I'm happy to be partnering again with today's sponsor, Ground News. Ground News is a news aggregator that gathers all related articles from around the world in one place to give you context about the news you read. Ground News not only gives you a complete list of all headlines for a story so you can spot media narratives and bias, but also gives you a breakdown of each source's political leanings, factual reliability, and ownership. Take, for example, this story discussing the likelihood of frequent eruptions on Iceland's Reykjanes Peninsula during the next several decades. While covered in 35 separate articles, only 70% of the rated sources are considered to be highly factual. Thus, if we sort by the highest factuality category available to only include these sources, I can not only find the most reliable analysis in this subject, but also the original research paper which every article is referencing. This is why I use Ground News for easier research, and you can too, to better understand the latest scientific news or news in general. Go to ground.news/geologyhub to give it a try with plans starting as low as 83 cents a month. If you sign up through my link, you'll get 40% off the Vantage plan, which is how I get unlimited access to all features and have tailored my feed via the Discovery feature to show interesting scientific news stories. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In New Zealand, the infamous White Island volcano produced a new eruption, sending a sustained plume of ash and gases to an altitude of 5,000 feet or 1,524 meters. Heading over to Italy's island of Sicily, Mount Etna produced its strongest paroxysm or short-term uptick in eruptive activity of 2024, causing ash to accumulate on communities up to 25 kilometers away from this towering volcano. And in what is this week's top story, ground deformation is now occurring as magma is accumulating in not one, not two, but three separate sections of Hawaii's Kilauea volcano. These regions are as follows: Kilauea's summit caldera between Pahi crater and Mauna Ulu, and 2,000 feet west of Napau crater. While none of these three regions, if they were to be the site of a new eruption, would put structures at risk of being inundated by lava flows, the main concern is the apparent pathway magma has reopened in the subsurface of the East Rift Zone. July 22nd of this year marked the first time since 2018 that lava was confirmed to be moving within the East Rift Zone. With magma having pushed up overlying ground by as much as 3 inches since July 22nd, the following outcomes could occur during the next several days to weeks. The most likely outcome is that no eruption occurs as magma accumulation eventually slows or stops beneath the upper and Middle East Rift Zone. The second possibility is that an upper or Middle East Rift Zone eruption occurs, with an upper East Rift Zone eruption likely to only last a few hours, while a Middle East Rift Zone eruption could last for days to years. Third, especially due to resumed landrise at Kilauea's summit caldera where the vast majority of its recent eruptions have occurred, a new eruption could also begin there within the summit caldera. Fourth, the least likely but most concerning possibility, magma could move further downrift and begin accumulating beneath the first area populated with people and structures a mere 4 miles away to potentially place structures at risk. Heading east into the nation of Italy, this week saw Mount Etna produce its fifth paroxysm, or short yet violent burst of activity since 2024 began. This paroxysm occurred on August 4th and lasted for several hours, sending a sustained plume of ash to an altitude of 10 kilometers or 32,800 feet, which subsequently drifted towards the east, with ash particles and tephra accumulating to between 2 and 5 millimeters thick in several towns. As strong ash emissions continued, half-kilometer-high lava fountains were ejected into the air, with its fragments combining on the ground to form a lava flow that would eventually flow 870 meters downslope, covering 0.38 square kilometers of ground. More paroxysms are likely to occur this month, although most are likely to be a bit less explosive than the August 4th event. Meanwhile, in New Zealand, the infamous White Island volcano, which is centered 51 kilometers north-northeast of the city of Whakatane, produced a new eruption at 1 p.m. on August 9th. This eruption was fairly weak, but continuous, as an ash jet originated from a 3-meter-wide vent just west of where its crater lake edge is normally located. White Island's alert level was thus raised from 2 to 3, and persistent ash emissions rose to an altitude of 1,524 meters or 5,000 feet before largely ceasing 3 hours later. However, additional episodes of ash emissions occurred over portions of the following 2 days. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on August 11th of 2024.